We didn't get pronunciations or anything, but
there's not many here. On our team, let's see. It's number 3 is Alex Verita. Oh, what's your name, by the way?
Kaylin.
What?
Kaylin.
Kaylin, I'm Elijah.
We would be talking right now, but they're not ready, so okay. Because we took a little longer. JV. Okay, so we're live, so whenever it's on.
Monarchs win the tip. Emma Dargy with the ball. She passes it over to Foken. Over to Hannah Fulton. Back up to the top of the key, over to the left wing. Up back to the top. Emma Dargy down to Brooke in the corner. Into the middle of Priscilla. Now she goes up. It's good for two. The Knights take the ball down the back to the other end of the court. Passing around the outside, trying to get it into the big girls in the middle. Three from the corner. No good. Knights with the rebound. Put back up. No good again. Knights with the rebound yet again. Pass into the middle. Pass to the corner. Drive to the middle. Layup is no good. And both Dargy with the ball heading down.
And both teams have been playing a tough zone with Southeast in a 3-2 and the Monarchs in a 2-3.
Hannah Fulton drives. She goes up. She's fouled. It looks like it was on the floor. Monarch ball under the hoop. Fulton drives, passes it to Foken. It's stolen by a Knight player and heading down the other direction. Knight ball under the hoop.
This has been some tough defense from the Monarchs here.
Definitely. Knights with the ball on the outside of the arc. Pass across, it's stolen by Emma Dargy. She drives down to the other end. Passes it off to Brooke. Back up to Emma. Over to Foken. To Hannah Fulton. Priscilla in the middle goes up. Was fouled by number 30 of the Knights. Rianne May. Out is number 30, Rian May. Shot is no good. Rebounded by the Monarchs, but stolen by a Knight. Headed the other direction. Over to the right wing. Back to the top. Left wing. Drive to the middle. Over to the corner. Back up to the top. Great ball movement by the Knights throughout this game so far.
But they're still having a tough time breaking this Monarch defense.
I know that's one of the strong points that the girls go for. It's a three ball by number three, Alex Barada. That's her first points of the game. Both teams playing great defense so far in this game. 5 minutes, 18 seconds left in the first quarter. That's a three again by number 23, Rachel Foken.
And that was a great pick and roll play to get Rachel Foken open.
Knight's still trying to break that Monarch defense. They throw it into the middle, but it's tipped away by number 23, Rachel Foken.
And Southeast has been working hard to try to get that ball inside, but they've been struggling so far.
Knight's throwing the ball in. Set it up on the outside. Get it in the middle, finally. And it's tipped away by Priscilla O'Dowd. Knight ball again under the hoop.
Southeast did well there to get the ball inside, but it was just a great play from Priscilla Dowd to get that block.
Knight's still trying to get the ball in the middle. Monarch defense is just trapping on any situation possible, making it really hard for them, for the Knights to get anything done. 4 minutes and 30 seconds left in the first quarter.
Just nothing going on offense here for the Knights.
It was a three ball missed and rebounded by the Knights. Great steal by Rochelle Foken, heading the other direction. She passes it off to Brooke Hubert. She passes it out to Emma Dargy. Up to the top to Priscilla O'Dowd, over to Foken again for three. Good. That's two threes already by Rochelle Foken.
And Southeast so far has just been really struggling to find their stride, offensively and defensively.
Both teams playing great defense to start off this quarter. Monarchs playing a little bit better, holding the Knights to only 3 points at this moment. The current score is Monarchs 3, Knights 9. 3 minutes, 48 seconds left of the first quarter.
And the Monarchs have not committed a single foul yet.
Not too many players have fouls so far in this game, which is good, except for number 30, Rian May, does have two fouls, so she needs to watch what she's doing. Otherwise, that can hurt her in the long run. Number 32, Jordan Long, checks in for the Monarchs.
You gotta assume in that last timeout, the Knights coach, Graham, was trying to get her team an offensive strategy to break this Monarchs defense.
Definitely, because they're going to have to, because the Monarchs are just playing too well right now. They drive to the middle, puts it up. She may have been fouled, it looks like, by Emma Dargy, if I'm correct. Yes, Emma Dargy's first foul. First shot is good.
And if the Knights want to win this game, they do not want to be playing from behind.
Second was good. Emma Dargy bringing the ball down the court for the Monarchs. Priscilla for two. No good. Good fight by the Monarchs for that ball. Jump ball. Night ball under the hoop, heading the other way.
And Southeast has really been struggling to rebound the ball here so far in this game. They do have a size disadvantage down in the low block compared to the Monarchs, and that's just been leading to them not being able to get the ball on the rebound.
Yeah, I agree. That's really helped the Monarchs throughout the season is the offensive and defensive rebounds. That is a layup by number 5, Carson Underwood. That's 4 points for her. As I was saying, yeah, the Monarchs have a big size difference on most teams, allowing them to get those offensive boards and turn those into points, or even the defensive boards and take those offensive boards away from the other team. Jordan Long goes up. She is fouled by number 23 of the Knights.
The Knights don't have a single player over 6 foot, while the Monarchs have 3, and that's really going to affect the Knights going down the stretch in rebounding and just in low block play.
Yeah, and the first shot is no good by Jordan Long. She missed the second, and the Knights get the ball back. Monarchs with the ball at the top of the key. Still trying to get into the big girls.
And since that timeout a few minutes ago, the Southeast has been playing a lot better defensively, and the Monarchs haven't had a single point.
They must have said something right in that half. Jordan gets it into Priscilla O'Dowd. She goes up. That's 2 points. Priscilla with 5 points this so far. She drives, Knights drive in the middle, and it is a jump ball again. Monarch ball heading the other direction. Number 3, Alex Barada, and number 22, Emma McKillop, check in for the Knights. And number 2, Hannah Fulton for the Monarchs, and number 44, Jamie Anderson. Darge with the ball on the outside. Brings it over the right side. Gets it into Jordan Long. She is fouled from behind by number 44, Alexis Dietz. That's her first. Emma Darge throws it into Jordan Long, and that's good for another 2 points.
After having within two, the Monarchs are now up by 6.
55 seconds left in the first quarter. Rebound by the Monarchs. Emma Dargie's struggling to handle the ball this game. Hannah Fulton with the ball. She passes it off to Jamie Anderson for two. No good. Looks like an over-the-back call on number 32, Jordan Long of the Monarchs. Knight basketball. Number 42, Haley Green checks in for the Knights.
One of the Knights' best players, Rian May, is still sitting on the bench because of foul trouble.
That could really hurt them in the long run. She watch when she comes back in, she needs to make sure she doesn't foul at all. Ball is almost stolen from Knights. Knights still struggling to break this. For a three, that is number 10, Maria Dreeves. Three ball by Brooke Huber from way downtown, no good. And that's our quarter. The score is 13-10, Monarchs. It was a great half by break. Quarter by both teams. Both teams playing great defense and staying pretty much out of foul trouble for the most part, except for Rianne May for the Knights. What do you think the Knights are talking about in their huddle so that they come out and come back in this game?
Well, they got to find a way to get something going for them offensively. They've only been able to shoot outside shots. And that's just not the Knights' game. The Knights' game is to get the ball into low block and try to get some easy layups or to get fouled.
I agree. Now, I think the Monarchs are just talking about how they need to just watch their fouls, can't make any big mistakes, and just keep playing the way they are. Get the ball inside of their big girls and stop the Knights from getting it inside like they've been doing. If they do that, they're going to be in good shape. But the Knights are no way out of this game. Only down 3. It is night ball heading into the second quarter.
And checking back into the game is number 30, Rianne May. So we'll see if she gets any fouls called on her this quarter. And if she does, it could really hurt the Knights late in the game.
Yeah, she can really not afford to get anything.
And she was open down low there for a second. They just couldn't find her down low to get the ball to her.
I think it's partly because the Monarchs are just so tall that they don't think they can force that ball through. Knights still passing around the outside. Rochelle Folk. That is number 30, Rianne May for 3.
And you see what Rianne May brings to the game there. She's one of the best 3-point shooters for the Knights.
Definitely come in and hit a 3 right off the bat. That's pretty good. Emma Dargy in the corner. Passes into Priscilla O'Dowd. She goes up. Shot is no good. It is on number 42, Haley Green. 2 shots for Priscilla. Correction. Foul is on Carson Underwood. First shot is good by Priscilla O'Dowd.
And the Monarchs have been doing a lot better job getting the ball inside, and it's led to them shooting more free throws than the Knights.
Generally, the team that shoots the more free throws and makes them wins ball games. Great job by Brooke Hubert making the girl turn around. Still trying to get inside. They get it to have the free throw line.
And the Knights are still just passing the ball around the perimeter. They cannot find anything inside.
Hannah Fulton for 3. No good. Knight ball. Knight rebound.
And there must have been some sort of defensive miscommunication there. She was wide open. She just couldn't convert.
Knights still passing that ball around the outside. There you go, she gets it inside. She did travel though, so Monarch ball. Mistakes like that, you need to just eliminate as a whole if you want a chance to win a ball game. You can't have turnovers. Emma Dargy drives, passes it back out.
Tough defense here from the Knights.
Ball is tipped out of bounds by the Knights. Monarch ball under the hoop.
And it didn't look like Lexi Harrison was ready for the ball there.
I agree. Priscilla ball. Monarchs pass the ball away. Knights with the ball. She drives. Looks like she may have been fouled, but they didn't call it. There's the foul there on number 40, Lexi Harrison. That's her first. Knights get the ball in on the outside. Back to the top of the key. Over to the left wing. Back to the top. Left wing again.
The Knights are still just passing the ball around the perimeter. There is nothing inside for them.
Too much height by the Monarchs. Three ball is no good. Rebound by the Knights. Put back up. No good. Tipped out of bounds by the Monarchs. Knight ball.
Looks like it went off a Monarch player's knee.
Number 32, Jordan Long, checks in for the Monarchs. Knights still struggling to get the ball to the inside. Passing around the outside. Great ball movement so far. Brian May drives in. It's tipped away. Monarch ball. She passes it up to Rachel Fokin. She lay up no good. Rebound by Priscilla Dowd. And she is fouled.
That was some great fast break defense there for number 3, Alex Berida. She ran back down the court and contested the shot.
The foul is on number 22, Emma McKillop.
That would have been an easy basket for the Monarchs, but by some great effort, she got down the court and stopped the ball.
Yep. Passing the inside to Prosoto. She goes up. No good. Rebounded by the Knights. Carson Underwood with the ball. Passes to the corner. Back to three ball. No good. Rebounded by the Knights. Put back up. Tipped out of bounds by the Knights. Monarch ball. Headed in the other direction. Number 24, Mackenzie Beach, checks in for the Knights. And number 44, Jamie Anderson for the Monarchs. Emma Dargie brings the ball up the court. Score is still just 15-13 Monarchs. 4 minutes left in the second quarter. Ball is tipped out of bounds by the Knights. Monarch ball under the court backboard. Number 14, Brooke Huber checks in for the Monarchs. And number 2, Hannah Fulton. Brooke in the corner for three. No good. Rebounded by the Knights.
That was a great inbounds play to get her wide open. She just couldn't make the open three.
Great shot by number 3, Alex Berida. That's her 5th point of the game. Berida, correction. Hannah Fulton with the ball now. Over to Brooke Hubert. Hannah drives. Passes up to Jamie Anderson. She was fouled before that, though. Looks like the foul is on number 3, Alex Berida.
And as the Monarchs are now in the bonus, they'll be shooting 1-1 from the line.
Number 10, Maria DeVries checks in for the Knights. And number 40, Lexi Harrison check in for the Monarchs. First shot is no good, Knight ball.
You don't expect to see many air balls on free throws like that at the high school level.
Yeah. I don't know what was going on. So far, the Monarchs have hit their free throws for the most part. It's just, I guess Hannah wasn't in a zone. Knights still trying to pass the ball on the outside. They get it in the middle. They have to pass it right back out. Too tall. That's a number 30, Rianne May. Yet again, another three ball by her.
That was a high arcing three, but it was nothing but net.
Knights now lead the Monarchs 18-15 with 2 minutes and 25 seconds left in this half.
This is their first lead of the game. I think this lead can be attributed to some tough defense. The Monarchs are struggling to get anything going.
Yeah, they're just not finishing their layups. Jump ball down low. It's still Monarch ball onto the hoop, though. It's like an offensive foul on Priscilla O'Dowd of the Monarchs.
When she was turning to pass that ball, she elbowed Rianne May right in the face.
Monarch coach is not happy about that one, but you got to just play on. Great defense by Brooke Hubert. She tips it out of bounds on the inbound.
You got to see if the Knights can break this full court press here.
Almost tipped away again by Brooke Hubert. Try to get that trap in. Priscilla O'Dowd with the steal. She has the ball. She steps out. That means night ball. 1 minute, 54 seconds left in this half.
And that really bailed the Knights out there. They could not break the full court press.
Three ball. No good.
Back to my point, though. They can break the full court press. The Monarchs stole the ball. They stepped out of bounds.
Almost tipped away by the Knights. Brooke drives. She puts it up. No good. Rebounded. Put in by Lexi Harrison. Knights bring the ball down the court quickly. Passing around the outside. One minute and 12 seconds left. Another three ball. It is good. Rianne May again from three.
That was a little bit of a heat check there, but she drained it.
Monarch's trying to get it in the inside with 50 seconds left on the clock. It's stolen by number 5, Carson Underwood. She goes in and drives. She is fouled, and it is good. Fouls on number 14, Brooke Hubert, her first.
The Knights really have the momentum here.
Carson Underwood at the line, shooting one. Number 42, Haley Green, checks in for the Knights.
Southeast has been playing some great defense, and they've been draining their outside shots.
The free throw is good.
And as for the Monarchs, the offense they were playing in the full first quarter, which was they were getting the ball inside. That has been working for them this quarter.
Monarchs passing down the outside. Gets it into Lexi Harrison. It's up, and that's good. 21 seconds left in this half.
Looks like the Knights are going to be going for the last shot here.
It's up, and that is good. That's another 2 points for number 24, Mackenzie Beach. Last second shot. Oh, she traveled. 0.5 seconds left on the clock. That was actually a pretty close shot, surprisingly, for how far away she was. She was well over past half court. Looks like the refs are talking to see where the ball placement will be. Meanwhile, number 3, Alex Beretta, and number 30, Rianne May, check in for the Knights.
I think they may be checking the time on the clock here, actually. Looks like they're going to be adding time back on.
Looks like they're going to put 1 second on the clock. 0.8 seconds on the clock. All right. Night ball.
So there isn't enough time to catch and shoot here. And with how hot the Knights have been here in the past few minutes, I think it'd be incredible to see them make this, but I wouldn't doubt it either.
It's going to be real tough. Shots up. No good. Real close.
That was a well-drawn-up play there to end the half.
As we head into the half, your Knights lead 26-19 over the Monarchs. So far throughout this game, both teams are playing great defense, except that the Monarchs are playing zone, so it's really leaving the outside shot open for the Knights. And that's just really killing them because Rianne May is just hitting threes like nobody's business. What do you think?
I think that, the Knights, they've just been on fire from outside, like you said. I'm not sure if they can keep that pace up, though. And you got to wonder what defensive changes the Monarchs are going to make here.
I agree. Do they stick in the zone, or do you think they go man-to-man to stop that three ball?
I think they'll stick in the zone here, but they'll maybe looking to contest shots faster and keep the ball outside and maybe let some inside passes occur.
Yeah. All right, we're good.
Nebraska won. Pettaway and Shields combined 53. Oh, Nebraska won 79-77. Damn.
right, and we are back in this second half where the Knights lead the Monarchs 26-19. Let's see if the teams can come out again with the strong defense they had the first half. Looks like it is Knights ball to start off this half.
And we'll see what halftime adjustments the Monarchs have made on defense. Looks like they are still in that 2-3 zone.
They look to be in more of a man-to-man.
Yeah, excuse me, yeah. I spoke too soon.
That hopefully will take away that three ball from Rianne May.
That was a great pass inside there from Emma McKillop, but Rianne May just couldn't handle the ball.
To drive by the Knights, pass it off. That's good for two for Emma McKillop.
And now that the Monarchs have gone to the man-to-man, the Knights look to be getting the ball inside with much more ease.
Definitely.
That is just one possession in.
Emma Dargie in the corner. Passes back up top. Monarchs still moving the ball around the outside, trying to get it inside to Priscilla O'Dowd or their big guy. Big girls, Rachel Fokin. Fokin for three. No good. There's a rebound by the Knights. Looks like there was a foul on that play by number 12, Emma Dargie. It's her second foul. First foul for the Monarchs this half. First free throw is good.
It does look to be more of a priority for the Knights to be getting the ball inside this half. So maybe that's what they talked about at halftime, is getting the ball inside.
And the second one's good as well. I'm going to argue with the ball. Anna Fulton drives, passes it out to Emma Dargie. Back into Priscilla O'Dowd for two, and it is good. Hard defense by the Monarchs trying to stop it. Oh, they get it down low. Knights, number 22, Emma McKillop for two. Your score is 32-21, Knights.
And on the first three possessions for the Knights, they've gotten the ball inside all three times.
Brooke Huber for three. It is good. Knights pass them around the outside, trying to get it in the middle again. They do. Back outside, though. Three ball. It is good by number 22, Emma McKillop. That's 7 points already this half for her.
And I don't think she was expecting to be that wide open. She got the ball, and she was looking for defense to come play defense on her. And there was no one that came, so she took the open shot.
Timeout by the Monarchs. They really, in this timeout, they're going to talk about how to play defense on them girls and not let them get those threes. The three ball is really what's killed them so far. It's not so much the inside ball, but letting them shoot those wide open threes and not even contesting that shot, that last three, that just cannot happen.
Gotta wonder, maybe the Monarchs will be going back to zone defense now that we've seen how easy Southeast has had it whenever they've been in a man.
Monarch with the ball. Madarga throws it into Brooke Hubert in the corner. She dribbles to the top, passes it over. Looks like there was a foul on that play.
The Southeast fans didn't seem happy with that call, but it was a foul.
The foul is on number 3, Alex Berta. That's her second foul of the game. Emma Dargy throws the ball into Priscilla Dowd. Up to Hannah Cahill. Foken for 3. It is good. Knights traveled. Monarch ball. Okay. Oh, double dribble. My mistake. Monarch ball. The score is 35-27. Knights. Mistakes like that are letting the Monarchs come back into this game. Ever so slightly, at least.
That's exactly what the Knights don't want here. But that was good for the Monarchs. They get another offensive possession.
3 ball by Bokuber is no good. It's rebounded by the Monarchs. Pass it back into Priscilla Dowd. It goes up, no good. Great box up by number 24, Mackenzie Beach of the Knights. Monarchs passing, Knights passing outside, rather. Gets into the inside. Rianne May drives, passes it back out. Rianne May in the corner. Passes into the middle. It is stolen by the Monarchs. Brooke Hubert driving to the other side. It is stripped away by the Knights. But she steps out of bounds. Monarch ball under the hoop.
That was just a great defensive play there from Carson Underwood. But the possession will remain with the Monarchs. We'll see what kind of offensive possession they get here.
Great hustle in that play. Priscilla Dowd. She hits it. 3 ball.
Nothing but net.
She is 6'1 and can still shoot threes. That's pretty crazy. Ball is almost stolen on that play.
And Southeast has been struggling to break that full court press.
Rianne May for 3. No good. Monarch rebound. Foken with the ball. Pass it off to Emma Dargy. She passes it up to Brooke Hubert in the corner. Down to Priscilla Dowd. She goes up. She is fouled by number 24, Mackenzie Beach of the Knights.
Just going back to that last offensive possession for the Knights. I think that was Rianne May's first missed three-pointer of this game. She's been having a great game, but you can't make them all.
That was a little farther out than her previous threes, though. Priscilla Dowd makes her first free throw. Number 2, Hannah Fulton, and number 3, Hannah McCarville, checking for the Monarchs, as well as number 23, Makeda Beeman, and number 32, Jocelyn Anderson for the Knights. Priscilla Dowd's second free throw is good. Number 32, Jordan Long, checks in for the Monarchs.
After being down almost 10, it's only a 3-point game here for the Monarchs.
Great comeback. Their full court defense is really stopping the Knights. They can't seem to handle the ball pressure.
And Southeast did a lot better job breaking the full court press there.
3 ball. It is good by number 3, Alex Berida. Hannah Cahill for 3. No good. Rebounded by the Monarchs. Put back up. No good. Knights head the other direction. She drives. Passes out to Rianne May. She drives herself. Tipped away by Hannah Fulton. Knight ball.
And just looking at the stats here, Papio is pretty one-dimensional on offense, with Priscilla O'Dowd and Rachel Falken scoring most of their points. Well, Southeast has had a lot of players score their points, but mostly Rianne May. Looks like she has scored 9 this game.
3 ball again. No good. Rebounded by the Knights, though. She might get another chance. Nope. She passes it off. Back into the middle. Drives out to the corner. Three ball by number three. No good. Tipped out of bounds by the Knights. Monarch ball. Number 34, Priscilla Dowd, and number 23, Rochelle Foken, check in for the Monarchs.
And Priscilla O'Dowd is the offensive leading scorer of the game, so that might be a good offensive boost for the Monarchs. She has 12 points.
Monarchs passing around the outside. Dargie tries to get it in the middle. It is stolen. Knights head in the other direction. Knights lead this one 38-32, 1 minute, 14 seconds left in this third quarter.
That was a good job by Rhiann May to get her hands up and to not allow the interior pass.
Knights may be trying to shed a little time off the clock at this one. Just passing around the outside.
After having a fast few minutes on offense, the Knights have really been struggling these last few minutes here in the third quarter.
Oh, Monarchs went from a zone defense now into man to try and make force the Knights to shoot. Rhiann May drives in the middle. It's tipped out of bounds by Emma Dargie. Looks like
now with only 25,
10.
Excuse me. Now with only 25 seconds left in the quarter, you got to wonder if the Knights are just going to play here for the last shot, or if they're going to try to get a quick basket and let the Monarchs take the last shot.
Looks like number 10, Maria DeVries, checks in for the Knights. Monarchs still in that hard one-man defense. Knights put a shot up. Looks like she was fouled, though. Fouls on number two, Hannah Fulton of the Monarchs. Looks like the Monarch coaches are not happy. They think that was a little too late to be called a foul.
That was a late whistle there from the ref.
First free throw is good by number 32, Jocelyn Anderson. And number 20, Jaden Moore, checks in for the Monarchs, as well as number 3, Alex Barada for the Knights. Second shot by Mackenzie Beach. Jocelyn Anderson in correction. And no good. Emma Dargie ball. Passes to the corner by Pye. No good. This is a close one here. The Knights lead. The Monarchs 39-32. The Knights are still playing that great defense that they did the first half. And the Monarchs are too, but the Monarchs are not able to finish on the offensive side of the court, and they are not stopping the Knights quick enough.
And even though it is a 7-point game, both teams are still very much in this game.
I think what the Monarchs are talking about in their huddle is that they just need to make their easy shots and not turn the ball over. That is the key to winning this game. If they want a chance to come back in this and make this 7 points back up, they just need to play their basketball and not let the Knights speed them up or play the way they don't want to.
And I'd expect the Knights to be talking about playing some tough defense because as they're holding a 7-point lead, if they can play some tough defense, the Monarchs will have a chance to get back into this game.
Definitely. Tough defense needs to be had by the Knights. They need to just keep playing the way they are and stop the Monarchs from doing anything if they want to just keep this lead and coast their way through to victory on this one. I personally think this is the most fun part of the game. The last 8 minutes of the game is where everything just goes crazy. The players just, they're well warmed up by this point, and everybody's playing to their best, and the Monarchs take the ball out, pass it in.
We sure are set up for a fun finish here.
Michelle Fokin, no good. Rebounded by Priscilla Dowd. She puts it up. She was fouled by number 42, Haley Green. That's her first foul. Priscilla Dowd hits that first one. Second one is good as well. That is 15 points by Priscilla Dowd in this game.
She is having a big game.
She has almost half of the Monarchs' points.
And it appears as if the Monarchs are remaining in that man-to-man defense here this quarter.
Two ball is good by number 10. Maria DeVries. Three ball by Priscilla Dowd, no good. Nice pass around the outside. Still trying to get on the inside. Monarchs playing good defense so far. She drives. Is forced back out. Ball is tipped away by Hannah Fulton.
Into the game here for the Monarchs is number 40, Lexi Harrison. And the Knights offense is being run through Rianne May right now.
Monarchs playing hard defense on Rianne May, making sure she does not get the chance to shoot those threes like she did in the first half. That really started the roll for the Monarch, for the Knights rather. She drives and that is good. That's her first 2 points of this half. Looks like an air ball by the Monarchs. Night ball.
And it's a 9-point game here. The Monarchs can't let this get too far away from them if they want to win it.
Number 10, Hannah Cahill checks in for the Monarchs. Knights take the ball out under the court, under the hoop. Inbound. Number 5, Carson Underwood sets it up for the Knights. Rianne May with the ball. She passes it in the middle. Back to Rianne May. She drives. It is blocked by Priscilla Dowd. And out of bounds on the Knights. Monarch ball. Number 14, Brooke Hubert checks in for the Monarchs.
And the Monarchs are making a great defensive effort. They're making it hard for the Knights to score here.
It's a great shot by Priscilla O'Dowd on that. Good for 2 points. That is 17 points by Priscilla O'Dowd. A drive by the Knights. No good. Rebounded by Emma Dargie. Head in the other direction. She passes it off to Priscilla O'Dowd.
It's a 7-point game here. The Monarchs are going to have to get some points here.
With only 4 minutes 45 seconds left, the Monarchs need to keep holding the Knights if they want to have a chance. Looks like there was a foul on that play. Number 22, Emma McKillop. That's her second foul of the game.
Checking in is number 3, Alex Berida. For the Knights, that is.
Inbound is Priscilla O'Dowd, but it's taken by the Knights. Number 5, Carson Underwood brings the ball down the court for the Knights.
The Knights are taking their time on offense here. And every time they have the ball, there's a lot of time running off the clock, giving the Monarchs less time to come back.
3-ball by Rianne May from way downtown. It is good.
And in most cases, that'd be an ill-advised shot, but she drained it. She had just been on fire this game.
Only 5 points this half. Timeout is by Lincoln Southeast. I think they just want to regroup themselves and just play hard defense throughout this last 4 minutes, 14 seconds of this game. They're up by 10 right now. So they have some breathing room, but I'm sure they want to have a bigger lead than that. Monarchs, on the other hand, trying to just get something started, get on a roll, get some people making threes, just get it going.
Yeah, 10 points is definitely not too much for the Monarchs to overcome here.
I agree. Monarchs have some girls that can just hit threes, just like Rianne May, but they just have to hit them. Hannah Fulton, Emma Dargie, and Brooke Hubert are all pretty good at shooting threes, except earlier in this game, Hannah Fulton did airball one, so, I mean, they have to be on fire if they want a chance. Overall, great defense throughout this entire game. Both teams playing really hard. Monarch ball under the hoop. Inbound to Brooke Hubert. Passes it back to Emma Dargie. 4 minutes, 8 seconds left. Emma Dargie drives. Passes it out to Brooke Hubert for 3. It is good. Tipped out of bounds by the Knights. Monarch ball yet again. Score is 46-39. Number 23, Rochelle Foken, checks in for the Monarchs.
And Alex Berida was open there on the fast break, but Carson Underwood just couldn't make a good pass to get it to her. Monarchs are only down 7 right now, with 3 minutes and 45 seconds left. That's not too bad. That's not too much to overcome.
Emma Dargie drives. No good. Over the back of Priscilla O'Dowd. Night ball.
That was a good box really out there from the Knights to make sure Priscilla O'Dowd could not get to that rebound.
I agree. Nobody really in foul trouble this game, which is good for both teams.
Also, neither teams are in the bonus yet.
Rianne May drives. No good. Knight rebound, though. Blocked by Priscilla O'Dowd. Monarchs with the ball. 3-on-1. Priscilla O'Dowd drives, puts it up. Is good, and she is fouled by number 30, Rianne May. That is her third foul of this game. With 3 minutes, 13, 3:10 rather. She still needs to watch those fouls. Plenty of game left for the Monarchs. First free throw by Priscilla O'Dowd. It is good. That's a 3-point play by the Monarchs. The score is 46-42.
And who else would it be to have the and one there besides Priscilla O'Dowd? She has just been the best player for the Monarchs here.
She has nearly 20 points. She has 20 points this game. Priscilla O'Dowd is definitely the best player this game for the Monarchs. Rebound by the Monarchs, heading the other direction. Only down 4. Falcon drives, puts it up, and that's good. That makes the lead only 2 points for the Knights.
And Southeast has struggled to finish games this whole season, and they're really hoping they don't let this they don't lose this one here.
Yeah, it'd be a real tough one for the Knights. Oh, 2 shots. No good. Rebound by the Monarchs again. Emma Dargy with the ball.
But on the other hand, it'd be a great comeback for the Monarchs.
Knights have been doing a great job with defense until this last 2 minutes, I'd say. They just need to step it up and play the way they were playing before, and they'll be perfectly fine. Looks like there was a foul on that play by number 30, Rianne May again. That's her 4th foul. She needs one more, and she's out of here. That's no good. Number 14, Brooke Huber checks in for the Monarchs.
Now, I don't expect Rianne May to be taken out of the game. She's just such a dynamic player that if she fouls out, Knights coach Kara Graham is just going to let it happen.
Priscilla O'Dowd needs to just quit reaching over people. That's just not going to work. That's her 2nd over-the-back call. She just needs to accept the fact that she can't get that ball without getting a foul and just move on and head down the direction, play great defense instead of getting those lousy fouls. That's 3 fouls for her.
The Knights have been boxing out Priscilla O'Dowd really well. But whenever you're taller than the person boxing you out, it's easy to try to reach up and over the person and try to get the ball.
Timeout was called by the Lincoln Southeast Knights. During this timeout, they're just going to say, recollect themselves, trying to get their defense back to where it was throughout the entire game. There's 1:40 left. They just need to play hard defense to hold this lead of 2 and just finish their shots on offense. In the past 3 minutes almost, they haven't really finished their shots. They need to calm down like they were earlier and just make the shots they know they can make.
And they really want to get an easy basket here and make it a 2-possession game. And the Monarchs are going to want to play tough defense so they can get the ball back and go down the court and tie the game or even take the lead.
No matter the outcome of this game, it's been a real great game. Played hard. It's a hard-fought game by both teams. A great one to watch. It is night ball coming out of this timeout.
And you also got to expect here, the Knights are going to take it slow and take a lot of time off the clock and give Papio less time to go down and make a basket.
Monarchs, on the other hand, are going to play really, really hard defense, trying to get that steal right off the bat so they can have their chance to tie this game up. Knights do get the ball in almost. It is tipped away by Emma Dargy. She goes up. Lousy free throw. Lousy layup. She just needed to take her time. Looks like there's a foul on that play. Foul's on number 14, Brooke Hubert. That's her 2nd. Night ball into the hoop.
You were right, the Monarchs did play great defense on that inbound down here, but the Monarchs got the steal. They just couldn't convert on the layup.
Still playing hard defense. It's stolen by Emma Dargy. Monarchs need to take their time on this. Timeout called by the Monarchs. That was a great steal by the Monarchs. Knights just needed to calm down and move the ball next time they get that ball. They just need to pass it down the court, get great ball movement, not try and rush. Don't play to the Monarchs level.
And Monarchs coach Dave Hubert is going to be drawing a play here to try to get an easy bucket for the Monarchs.
Knights only lead by two with 1 minute and 21 seconds left. Monarchs are looking to at least tie this game up before half. Let's see if they can shove it into overtime or maybe hit a three and go up.
And Priscilla Dowd has 20 points. She's the leading scorer of the game. You've got to expect that they're going to be trying to get the ball to her on offense.
Priscilla Dowd may have 20 points for the Monarchs, but Rianne May herself has 14 points for the Knights. Both of the players are definitely playing really great tonight. Both of them seniors, being great senior leaders this year.
You gotta expect here that the Knights are gonna keep the ball away from Priscilla O'Dowd at all costs.
Monarch ball coming out of this timeout. Knights looking to play hard fought defense here. Looks like there was a foul on that play. Emma Dargie at the line. Foul is on number three, Alex Berida. That's her third foul. Emma Dargie's first shot is no good. Monarchs get the rebound though. Oh, she traveled. Knight ball heading the other direction with 1 minute, 14 seconds left. Rianne May with the ball on the outside, passes it in.
The Monarchs don't have to foul here. We're going to be playing some tough, tight defense.
It is stolen again by the Monarchs. Emma Dargie drives in, passes it off. Great job being unselfish right there. Number three, Hannah McCarville, makes her first points of the game, and she is fouled.
And what a great time for her to get her first points of the game.
That's her fifth. The foul is on number 30, Rianne May. That's her fifth foul. She is out of this game.
And with
that
this
is a big problem for the Knights. That's their highest, that's their point leader right now. They just cannot afford for that to happen. That is just not good.
The Knights do have other scoring options, but she is their number one scoring option. It's going to be tough for the Knights to not have her the rest of the way.
Yeah, I think you're right. Number 10, Maria DeVries checks in for the Knights. Shooting one, Hannah McCarvo. No good. So it is tied. Looks like there was a foul on that play. May have been on number 14, Brooke Hubert. Knight ball onto the hoop.
Yeah, it looks like Brooke Hubert pushed McKenzie Beach as McKenzie Beach is going for that rebound. It is a tie game here with a minute left. What a great finish this is going to be.
Another foul on number 12, Emma Dargie. Monarch coach is not happy with that call, but they can't just worry about them fouls. They just need to keep going. That puts the Knights into bonus. Shooting 1-1 is number 10, Maria DeVries.
The Monarchs are going to be trying to box out here and use their height advantage to get the rebound if Maria DeVries misses the first shot here.
First shot. No good. Rebound by Monarchs. 53 seconds left on the clock. Emma Dargie brings the ball up the court. Monarchs need to take as much time off the clock and then score. 42 seconds left. Monarchs still with the ball on the outside. Hannah McCarville.
And the last thing the Knights want to do right now is foul. As the Monarchs are in the bonus, they'll be going to the line. It appears as if the Monarchs won't be leaving much time for Southeast Gibson.
Uh-oh, that's a five-second call on the Monarchs. That is Knight ball heading the other direction, giving them the last chance. 19.5 seconds left. They've got... The Knights are going to try and get one shot after this. Looks like there was a timeout for the... The Monarch timeout. Monarchs, let's see if the Monarchs come out of this and try and get a steal like they have been the entire game. The Knights really just need to hold on to the ball, maybe score, but if they can, just send it us into overtime. That's their best chance, because then they get four more minutes to just show that which team is better.
And assuming the Knights do get the inbounds here, they'll have 20 seconds to get the ball down the court and try to get an open look.
Number two, Hannah Fulton checks it for the Monarchs. Great game by both teams so far. All right, Knight ball. 19.5 seconds left in this game. Score is tied, 46-46.
And the last thing the Knights want here is a turnover. Because if they commit a turnover, the Monarchs will have the ball and still a lot of time to go score a basket. 10 seconds remaining.
Knights trying to make this one last shot. It is tipped. And it is good by number 22. Emma McKillop.
The Knights fans are loving it.
Great finish by Emma McKillop. That's really what the Knights needed. Only 4.7 seconds left on the clock for the Monarchs to try and score.
And on that, Alex Baird was looking to get a nice pull-up jumper. It was blocked, but Emma McKillop was there for an easy lay-in.
All the Knights fans are standing up, cheering, because that was just a great play by the Knights. I think they might have this one won if the Monarchs cannot get the ball down the court in time. It's going to be real hard, but it is not impossible.
If you're Monarchs coach Dave Hebert here, what would you be drawing up for your team?
Directly after this game, we have the boys playing. Should be another great game.
I'd expect to see Priscilla O'Dowd be getting the ball here. She's just the best player on the team. Or at least this game she has been. And you gotta hope she can make her shot and send this game to overtime. Or even win it for the Monarchs.
I think you're right. Either it goes to Priscilla O'Dowd or maybe Brooke Huber, because she's a little faster, so she can get it down the court quickly. Either one. Both great players for the Monarchs.
And either way, this could be a great finish here.
I'm a Dargie with the inbound to Rochelle Folkin. 3 seconds.
This could be a long
two,
shot here.
One. They did not get the shot off. The Knights win the game 48-46. Hard-fought game by both teams. The Knights just prevailed on this. You said something about how the Knights were not good at finishing this games. I think they just proved you wrong. They heard you say that during the timeout or whatever, and they just wanted to prove us wrong. Great job by the Knights this game. They really pulled through and were able to finish it off. The Monarchs were able to come back from a 10-point deficit in the first half, but overall, the Monarchs can't be too upset. A 2-point loss, I mean, yeah, you lose, but they played very hard throughout the entire game.
And this hasn't been the best season for the Knights, but maybe this is what they need to get their season back on track. And I'd be like to be the first person to wish both these teams the best of luck in the rest of their seasons.
Thank you for watching the girls' game, and thank you to Lincoln Southeast for allowing us, for hosting us here and allowing our broadcasting crew to come to this game. We'll be back with the boys' game.